So let's do a concrete example of crossover. And so it turns out that the crossover operation is always going to depend critically on how you represent the input space. So let's say concretely that our input space is 8-bit strings. So here's two parents, 0110 1100 and 1101 0111, and we're going to introduce them to each other. All right, now they know each other.
Mm-hmm.
And now we're going to use them to create a new individual, a new offspring.
So they're really going to know each other.
All right, now we've put these two bit sequences together, and we've lined up so that the bits correspond in each of the different positions. And now we can ask, how can we use this to generate a new individual that uses elements of the two individuals that we had? So
I have
some ideas.
Can
you think of any ways to do that? Yeah, okay, what do you got?
I have lots of ways, but I don't think any of them can be reproduced for the purposes of this learning lesson.
All right, well, so let's do ones that really kind of stick to the bit patterns.
I swear, there's no way you could say this without getting in trouble, Michael.
All right.
But that's okay. So how about, here's an obvious one, right? If we really push the genetic notion as far as we can, then, you know, each of those things represent, I don't know, alleles or some other biological term. And so what happens in genetics, right, is you mix and match your chromosomes and your alleles together. So why don't I say one child is the first four bits of this handsome Charles fellow and the last four bits of this beautiful and wonderful Sheila person.
All right, I see what you're doing there. So what you're saying is we're going to pick, well, maybe this isn't quite what you said, but I'm imagining that what you said is we pick a random position along the sequence, and you said at the halfway point, and what we're going to do is now mix and match and create two offspring. One uses the first half of Charles and the second half of Sheila, and then the other one is the other way around. And as you can see, it's this last bit that determines the sex. Anyway, so these are the two offspring that these two individuals have generated. And this particular way of combining, where you randomly choose a position and then flip-flop, is called one-point crossover. All right, so now I want you to think about this for a second, Charles. So I don't know if it's an inductive bias, but what kind of bias do we put in when we say, well, we're going to choose one of these points and we're going to flip-flop based on where that point is chosen? Like what kind of offspring is that going to generate?
I see two kind of assumptions built there. So maybe that is an inductive bias. So, or a bias of some sort. So one assumption is that locality of the bits matter.
Good.
Right? So the first, by picking halfway through, you're saying the first four bits are somehow related, and the last four bits are somehow related, because otherwise it wouldn't make any sense. To talk about them being together. And that brings me to my second point, which I guess really is just the first point, which is that it assumes that there are subparts of the space that can be kind of independently optimized that you can then put together. Right? And in particular, when I say subspaces to optimize, I mean that they're independent part of the subspaces. So that's actually the example that you gave before. You said, well, there's these two dimensions, and each dimension kind of matters independently. And the total reward or the total fitness is some kind of linear combination of them. And so I can put them, because if those two things aren't true, then really doing crossover like this won't help you at all. You're just kind of randomly mixing things together.
It's kind of an assumption about the way the space works, in that kind of like the example we did when we were doing bit guessing, that that you can be heading in a good direction, that there's pieces that are right, and if we reuse those pieces, we can get even righter.
Sure.
All right. So, and if it is the case that the sequence of the ordering of the bits matters, we have this locality property, this is actually a fairly sensible thing to do. But can you imagine any other way of combining these bits together to get offspring?
Well, I can think of a lot.
Well, so let's focus, you know, you have many different possible ideas, but let's focus on ideas where we still have this subspace to optimize property, but we don't really have a locality of bits property, that we don't really the ordering doesn't matter anymore. So keeping them clumped together like that, we don't think that that's a useful thing.
Okay, well, what would that mean? Tell me what that means.
Well, so the one-point crossover, when we talked about that, it really matters that, you know, the two bits that are next to each other are very likely to stay connected, right? That it's unlikely that the split will happen to happen exactly between them, and so they'll tend to travel as a group. But if we don't think it's important that the bits that are next to each other need to travel together, if we say that it should be equally likely for any of the bits to kind of remain together. We need to cross over a lot more than just that one time. And in a sense, we might need to cross over every time. Well, so what I'm trying to get at here is this notion that what we could do is we can generate individuals by just scrambling at each bit position.
Okay.
So the first bit position, maybe it stays the same. The second one flips. The third one stays the same. The fourth one stays the same. The fifth one flips. The sixth one stays the same. Seventh one flips. And the eighth one stays the same. So now we've got two individuals, and every bit from these individuals comes from one of the parents. And so that means that if there's little subpieces that are correct, that may be preserved in the offspring. But no longer does it matter what the ordering is. We get exactly the same distribution over offspring no matter how we order the bits.
Okay.
So this idea is sometimes called uniform crossover, and essentially we're just randomizing at each bit position. This kind of crossover happens biologically at the level of genes, right? So we imagine that we get our genes from our parents, but for each different gene, like the gene for eyes and the gene for hair color, are not particularly linked to each other, that they're uniformly chosen at each position.